Today we're taking a look at somewhere located just right down the street from our school. It's VISTI. VISTI means Volunteers in Service to the Elderly. Let's go in and ask Mrs. O'Reilly, the Executive Director of VISTI, to tell us all about this service. Hello, Mrs. O'Reilly. When did VISTI start?
VISTI started 25 short years ago with 48 clients. Today we served over 12,500 elderly individuals. We serve Lakeland, Bartow, Fort Meade, and Mulberry.
What is the mission of VISTI?
The mission of VISTI is to enable the frail elderly to remain safely and independently in their own homes. We do this by providing home services of transportation, commodities, hot meals, respite, housekeeping, lifeline, just about anything that you take for granted, we do for the elderly.
Do people come here to receive food or do you deliver it to them?
That's a great question, Elizabeth. We have clients that come here and pick up their month's worth of food every single month, and there's about 600 of them. And then we deliver to about 550, and we utilize our volunteers to make those deliveries and to assist the clients that come here. It's a huge commodity program, and we're very proud of what we do. But we also know that the food that we give those people each month enables them to live safely and independently in their own home. That's what makes nutrition so important.
Lions, VISTI really needs our assistance. So what can we do here at Philip O'Brien Elementary to help? Hey, I know, we can start a canned food drive. Starting on Monday, please bring in non-perishable items to our school. That means things that don't go bad. Your teachers will have boxes inside their classroom to collect them. The canned food drive ends on Thursday, December 18th. So please, participate in this wonderful project. Give to others this Christmas season. And hey, let's help all year round. I'm Elizabeth Nichols, reporting here at VISTI. What's up, guys? I'm just rocking around these Christmas trees at United Methodist Temple, located on South Florida Avenue. Here with me today is a volunteer at the Christmas tree lot. It's Mr. Hammer. So Mr. Hammer, I see lots of different trees around here, and I'm still looking for the perfect one for my house. So what kinds of trees do you sell?
This one right here is a nice tree. That's a Fraser fir. I think it would go good in your house. We also sell Scotch pines, and we also sell Colorado blue spruce.
So what is the most popular tree?
Most popular tree we got is Fraser firs, like this one right beside you. Next most popular is the Scotch pines, and the least popular is the Colorado blue spruce, because they're very sticky. And if your cat jumps into them, he'll only do it once, because they'll stick him.
That's funny. So. Since they don't grow around here, where do they all come from?
Well, these Fraser firs come from North Carolina, and the Scotch pines came from Michigan. They came in on a semi and they were full of snow, and all the kids were making snowballs and having a snowball fight the day they came in, and they had a great time.
Wow, I wish I could have been here to see that.
I wish you could have too. They had a lot of fun.
So, how much is the price range of their cost?
The little ones way down on the end are Scotch pines, and we sell those for $20, and the biggest one is a 12-foot Fraser fir, and that goes for around $200.
Wow, that's a lot of trees. So, what do you do with all the profits that you have made?
We give all our profits to local charities, so be sure and tell all your friends to come down and buy a tree from us.
Thank you, Mr. Hammer, and I'll be sure to tell all my friends about this Christmas place.
Thank you, Elizabeth.
I'm Elizabeth, reporting for Lion Kingdom News.
Thanks, girls. The playground is an exciting place in our school. Let's walk around and see some of the seven most favorite things to do here in the playground.
I like to play basketball.
I like to play on the walk wall.
So what do we have here, Mia?
The driving wheel. I like to practice my driving.
So what do you like to do at the playground, Jasmine?
Play on the monkey bars.
I like to swing.
I like the old monkey bars.
So what's your favorite thing to do, Kevin?
Slide down.
Then take off. Well, there you have it. 7 fun things that we like to do on our brand new playground. I'm fixing to go head off to the monkey bars. But before I do, I'm Elizabeth Nichols reporting for Lion Kingdom News. Back to you, girls.
Good morning, Lions. I'm here with Coach O'Neill after the Red Ribbon Run. It turned out to be a beautiful day.
It did, Elizabeth.
And it had a great ending. We won the participation trophy.
Yay!
So how many years have we won the trophy?
That's our 17th year in a row.
Wow, we must have a lot of trophies in that trophy case.
We do.
How many people participated in this year's run?
Well, Elizabeth, we had 352 students.
Way to go, Lions! So what's the real reason that we support the Red Ribbon Run?
Well, actually, it's to have students live a healthy lifestyle, saying no to drugs and alcohol.
Wow, that's a pretty good reason.
Great reason.
It was a lot of fun. I can't wait till next year.
Me neither.
Thanks, Coach, for inspiring us.
You're welcome.
I'm Elizabeth reporting for Lion Kingdom News. Back to you, Zachary. Have you been to the bookstore lately? Well, if you haven't, there's lots of new things. Let's check it out. Wow, we have a large variety of supplies in here. And if you don't know what the word variety means, then you need to stop by and get a dictionary for only $2.50. And if you come to school without a pencil, you need to get one for 25 cents here at the bookstore. They even have scented ones. My favorite's cherry, but you might like strawberry, bubblegum, grape, or even lime. If you make a lot of mistakes, you might want to have an extra eraser. They have some here for only 25 cents. Hey, and don't forget about those t-shirts and the sweatshirts for cold mornings. They're only $12. Enough of listening to me. You'll have to come by and check it out yourself. And hey, maybe you'll run into me sometime. I'm Elizabeth Nichols, reporting at the Philip O'Brien Elementary Bookstore.
Good morning, sports fans. Last night at the Trop, the Rays won game number 2 of the World Series with a score of 4-2. Way to go, Rays! Game number 3 will be played at Citizens Bank Field in Philadelphia on Saturday, 8 p.m. Don't miss it. You can catch the game after the Red Ribbon Run on Saturday. Remember, Lions, the Red Ribbon Run will be held at George Jenkins Athletic Field tomorrow morning. Please report to the sign-in table no later than 7:30. Remember to wear your school t-shirt and your best running shoes. See you there. I'm Zachary Simon, and I approve this message.
Good morning, fellow citizens. I'm Abraham Lincoln, the 16th president. I was born on February 12, 1809. That was 200 years ago. Man, I'm old. I was the tallest president, measuring 6'4", and I was the first president to have a beard. I also loved pets. Let's see. I owned horses, cats, dogs, and even a turkey. My face appears on the $5 bill and the penny. I've been called the greatest U.S. president in history. See you next time you visit the Lincoln Memorial.
Good morning, Lions. Today is Veterans Day. Millions of people around the world served our country. I'm here with Lance Corporal Justin Bergstrom.
Good morning.
Good morning. So what branch of service have you served in?
The Marine Corps.
Wow, I heard that's one of the toughest to serve in.
Yes.
So where did you serve?
I've been to Iraq, and I am stationed in North Carolina.
Wow. So what did you do in Iraq?
We ran security missions for higher official Iraqis. We rebuilt the Iraqi police department to be able to take care of the city on their own, and we turned it over to them before we left. And we rebuilt their government to be more like our own.
So what is the country like?
The country is sandy, except for the richer people's houses. They have grass in their yards instead of sand. It's really hot. It got up to 150, 155 one day. And it's usually just sandy all around.
So what are the people like?
They're nice. They are like everyone here. Some people are easy to get along with. Some people aren't. They're just like everybody here.
So are you happy to be home?
I'm very happy to be home.
And we're happy that you're home with us too.
Thank you.
Thank you for serving our country.
No problem.
I'm Elizabeth, reporting for Lion Kingdom News. Welcome to the 2008-2009 Walkathon. And to make it all happen is the Walkathon man, Mr. Montanez.
How are you doing, Elizabeth?
I'm good.
Good, good.
Thank you so much for coming out to our school.
Well, I'll tell you what, it's a pleasure always coming to Phil O'Brien School because you know what? You guys are great. You get out there, I mean, starting from the top all the way down. It is an awesome school, and we always have a great time at this school.
So how long have you been doing walkathons?
Well, you know, this is our 9th year, and we've actually been here 9 years at your school also. So you were one of our first schools that we started, and Coach O'Neill, so it's been a lot of fun so far.
Wow, we've been doing this for a long time.
Yeah, you have.
How many schools participate?
Well, you know, we're on pace right now to do 60 schools this year, so we've done already, about 38 schools already this year.
So, for students in our school, what is the average laps that they usually run or walk?
Well, it really depends. Like the primary, the little guys, K through 2, they usually go about, I'd say anywhere from 10 to 20 laps. And then the older students, the intermediate students, they go about 25 to 30 laps.
So when we get all the money raised, what are we going to use it for?
Well, you guys have been really, really fortunate because you've gotten like those little Mr. Machines and also help for pavilions. But Coach has, this year he's allocated the money to get new PE equipment.
Well, that's cool. I can't wait. The 3rd through 5th grades are fixing to go running, so I'm going to run off and join them. I'm Elizabeth, reporting here at the Walkathon.
Good morning, Lions. I'm Krista, and I'm here on School National Lunch Week with Miss Renee. Miss Renee, how many meals do you serve a day?
Well, between breakfast and lunch, anywhere from 600 to 700.
Wow, that's a lot. How early do you have to get up?
I get up at 5 o'clock in the morning, but I have to be here at 6:30.
How do you go about making sure we get nutritional meals each day?
Well, on the line, we make sure that we have fresh vegetables and fresh fruits and the main dish they can choose from.
What do you think is the most popular food at O'Brien?
Oh, it's got to be Friday Pizza Day, of course.
Everybody orders that one.
Yes.
Thank you very much, Mr. Ryan.
You're welcome.
Back to you.